Good morning and Vanakkam. In this video, we're going to be reading from Dancing with Shiva, Hinduism's contemporary catechism, written by Sadhguru Saivite Subramanian Swami. A richly illustrated sourcebook of Indian spirituality in question and answer form, exploring how to know the divine, honor all creation and see God everywhere, in everyone. Today's lesson is lesson 86 and we'll begin by reading the caption to the facing image. Mythologically, Lord Skanda was born to protect the world. With peacock and fighting rooster in support, he confronts the demon Surapadma with his veil, then hurls his vajra, lightning bolt. We too must bravely face adversities on our path. Lesson 86. How do we overcome life's obstacles? Shloka 86. Just as a small leaf can obscure the sun when held before our eyes, so can the past cloud the present and hide our divinity. With Vedic methods or tantras, we remove impediments to reveal the ever-present inner light. Om. Bhashya. An ancient Upanishad defines 20 obstacles, upasarga, to spiritual progress: hunger, thirst, laziness, passion, lust, fear, shame, anxiety, excitement, adversity, sorrow, despair, anger, arrogance, delusion, greed, stinginess, ambitiousness, death and birth. Another obstacle is the intellect, which, unguided by intuition, merely juggles memory and reason as a way of life. The experience of these impediments creates reactions that combine with the sum of all past impressions, samskaras, both positive and negative. Residing in the subconscious mind, these are the source of subliminal traits or tendencies, called vasanas, which shape our attitudes and motivations. The troublesome vasanas clouding the mind must be reconciled and released. There are beneficial tantras by which absolution can be attained for unhindered living, including Ayurveda, Jyotisha, daily sadhana, temple worship, selfless giving, the creative arts, and the several yogas. The Vedas explain, even as a mirror covered with dust shines brightly when cleaned, so the embodied soul, seeing the truth of Atman, realizes oneness, attains the goal of life, and becomes free from sorrow. In this video, we're going to be reading from Living with Shiva, Hinduism's contemporary culture, written by Sadhguru Saivite Subramanian Swami. 365 daily lessons based on ancient Vedic laws, disclosing how to approach family, money, relationships, technology, food, worship, yoga and karma to live a truly spiritual life. Today's lesson is lesson 86 and the topic is establishing your sadhana. Many of you here today have studied with me for some time and understand how a good religious life can be lived in this technological age. You have learned how to pass the knowledge of Saiva Dharma on to the next generation, the next and the next, but you may not yet feel fully confident to teach Saiva Dharma outside your home and immediate family. All of you are preparing yourselves to be teachers of Saiva Dharma so that the Saivite who has not had the benefits of knowing a lot about his religion may know more, so that the Hindu who does not have the benefit of knowing whether he is a Saivite, a Vaishnavite, a Shakta, or a Smarta may learn the difference and then fully practice one of these four great religions of our heritage. In order to teach with confidence, you must train yourselves. Since this is an inner teaching, you must train yourselves inwardly through the regular daily practice of sadhana. Who sets the course of sadhana? The course of sadhana can be set by an elder of the Hindu community. It can also be set by one Sadguru. Your mother and father, who are your first gurus, can also set the course of sadhana for their children. Or it can be set by yourself from a book. There are many fine books available outlining the basics of yoga, sadhana, and meditation. Where does sadhana begin? It begins within the home and it begins within you. This is ancient wisdom recognized not only in India, but among many great civilizations of history. Thus, upon the wall of a famous ancient Greek temple and oracular center at Delphi was inscribed, "Know thyself." The religion of the Greeks, which was in many respects not unlike Hinduism, is long since gone, but remaining temple ruins testify to its magnificence. By disciplining your mind, body, and emotions through sadhana, you come more and more into the inner knowing of yourself. You will first discover that when the breath is regulated, it is impossible for the thinking mind to run wild. And when the breath is slightly held, it is impossible for more than one thought to remain vibrating in the mind at a time. You will experience that when the nerve currents are quieted through diaphragmatic breathing, it is impossible to be frustrated, and it is possible to absorb within yourself, into the great halls of inner learning, into the great vacuum within you, all of your problems, troubles, and fears without having to psychoanalyze them. Through the regular practice of scriptural study, which is a vital part of your daily sadhana vigil, you will soon find that it is possible to touch into your superconscious mind and complement that study with your own inner knowing. After you are well established in your sadhana, you will enjoy a greater ability to discipline your body, your breath, your nerve system, and your mind. We first have to learn that in order to control the breath, we have to study and understand the breath, the lungs, how the body is constructed, and how the pranas move through it. This enables us to understand the subtle system within the body that controls the thinking mind. Then we are ready to study the mind in its totality. Sutra 86 of the Nandinada Sutras. caring for one's wife. Each of Shiva's married men devotees loves and cares for his wife, despite any shortcomings. He is forbidden to strike or speak harshly to her or ignore her needs. If he does, he must seek family and professional help. Om. Good morning and Vanakkam. In this video, we'll be reading from Merging with Shiva, Hinduism's Contemporary Metaphysics, written by Sadhguru Saivite Subramanya Swami. 365 Enlightenment Lessons from a Mystical Master, revealing the depths of Raja Yoga, the clear white light, the states of mind, and the ultimate spiritual destiny of every seeker. Today's lesson is Lesson 86, and the topic is Step 2, Concentration. Then we automatically move into the next step, concentration. The hummingbird poised over the flower held at attention begins to look at the flower, to concentrate on it, to study it, to muse about it, not to be distracted by another flower. That is then awareness moving. Awareness distracted here is awareness simply moving to another flower or moving to another area of the mind. Give up the idea that thoughts come in and out of your mind like visitors come in and out of your house. Hold to the idea that it is awareness that moves rather than the thoughts that move. Look at awareness as a yo-yo at the end of a string. The string is hooked to the very core of energy itself, and awareness flows out and it flows in. Awareness might flow out toward a tree and in again, and then out toward a flower and then in again, and down toward the ground and then in again. This is the wonderful yo-yo of awareness. That is a good concept to grasp in order to become more acquainted with awareness. Awareness held at attention can then come into the next vibratory rate and concentrate. Take a flower and place it in front of you. Breathe deeply as you sit before it. Simply look at it. Don't stare at it and strain your eyes, but simply become aware of it. Each time awareness moves to some other area of the mind, with your willpower, move awareness back and become aware of the flower again. Keep doing this until you are simply aware of the flower and not aware of your body or your breath. Then begin to concentrate on the flower. That is the second step. Think about the flower. Move into the area of the mind where all flowers exist in all phases of manifestation and concentrate on the flower. Move from one area to another, to where all stems exist, to the stem of that particular flower, to the root that that particular flower came from, and to the seed. Concentrate. Concentrate, concentrate on the flower. This is what concentration is, remaining in the thought area of the particular item that you are aware of and flowing through the different color and sound vibrations of the thoughts. How does it work? The powers of concentration. It is only a name. Actually, what is happening is you are flowing awareness through the area of the mind which contains the elements which actually made that particular flower, and you are perceiving how all those elements came together. And that's it for today's lesson. Take care of yourself, have a beautiful day, and we'll see you in the next video. Om Namah Shivaya.